Hello and welcome to Storyboard. This is Shibani Gharat, former PepsiCo India chairman and CEO D. Shivakumar. Has been elected as the new chairman of the country's advertising watchdog, the Advertising Standards Council of India, popularly known as ASCI. Speaking to Storyboard's Farah Bukwala Vora, Shivakumar lays down his top focus areas as he takes the reins of ASCI and explains why self-regulation is, in fact, in the best interest of all economic sectors.
With 2 decades of experience in sales, marketing and management positions across India's top consumer companies, including Nokia, Hindustan Unilever and PepsiCo, D. Shivakumar, popularly known as Shiv, has been on ASCI's Board of Governors for 3 years, earlier serving the association as its vice chairman. At ASCI's 32nd AGM held earlier this month, Shivakumar, who is presently the Group Executive President for Corporate Strategy at the Aditya Birla Group, was unanimously elected as ASCI's new chairman, taking over from Abanti Sankaranarayanan. Speaking to Storyboard, Shivakumar explains how his primary objective to widen ASCI's member base is central to the idea of self-regulation and better compliance to ASCI's code of conduct.
You've been on the Board of Governors for the past 3 years and now you're taking over as chairman. What would your immediate focus areas be? What would your priority areas be as you take over the reins of ASCI?
Yeah, I would say 3 things. I think first is to increase the awareness of ASCI amongst ordinary consumers. That's extremely important. Second is to build the ecosystem of ASCI along with regulators, along with government, along with advertisers, along with advertising agencies and media owners. And third, as new things develop, especially digital, how do we really formulate policy or think about it? Is something that I would like to look at. So those are the 3 things which are on top of my mind.
Okay. Mr. Shivakumar, we've seen that, you know, the spate of misleading or false advertisements has seen a drastic rise over the years. And in fact, some of the categories that stand out are medicine and education. What can you do at ASCI to specifically reduce the number of complaints or misleading advertisements that are coming out of these two very consumer-centric sectors?
Yeah, I think the first thing is we need to broaden the pool of people who are part of ASCI. We need to get new sectors in. You mentioned education, health, insurance, e-commerce, etc. We need to bring more people in and engage a lot more with these new sectors so that people are aware that self-regulation is actually good for every sector. I don't think people truly understand that today. Self-regulation involves negotiation, seeing the other person's point of view. It's not about formulating law and then implementing it.
ASCI, over the last 2 years, has launched many such initiatives to get more direct complaints. One of it was the launch of your WhatsApp number. What has the response been to this very consumer initiative? And what is the target as far as the mix between suo motu surveillance complaints that you assess and the direct complaints that ASCI is receiving? How do you propose to take the direct complaints system forward?
Yeah, so I think using as much digital as possible, WhatsApp is an example, email is another example, etc. Using as much of digital as possible will only help ASCI. I have not sat down with the team or set any target specifically for this year. But as I mentioned, my first priority would be to increase the awareness of ASCI amongst the ordinary consumers.
Well, Mr. Shivakumar, one of the criticisms against ASCI has been that while it is an executive arm of the Ministry of Ayush, the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting and the Department of Consumer Affairs, and it proactively engages with advertisers who are flouting the ASCI codes, it does not have enough powers of enforcement because it's a self-regulatory body. So the criticism that often comes your way is that ASCI is what you call a toothless tiger. How can you, and especially now that you take over as the new chairman, what are you likely to do in order to ensure that ASCI develops more teeth?
See, the whole ecosystem that we work in, so you have regulators, you have government, you have Ministry of Ayush, you have the FSSAI, you have the advertiser. That body, the more we broaden the ecosystem, I think the better the compliance will be. I think today the ecosystem is narrow. Yes, we have a lot of backing from the government, but we are still a self-regulatory body. So, and we must recognize that self-regulation has so many dimensions to it and so many constraints on it. Okay, the more broader we make the people who participate with ASCI, I think we will see better response.
But do you feel that there is a need for a change in the perception of ASCI as well?
No, I don't think so.
Not really?
Not at all.
Okay, all right. The other criticism that also comes is that the amount of time it takes for resolutions to be eventually made by the consumer complaints. So the amount of time it takes for the due diligence process allows or gives a leeway to the advertisers who are flouting to eventually continue with the print advertisements or the TVCs. What can you do to fast track the resolution of complaints?
So we do have a very clear mechanism, the way the whole complaint system is handled. Every system, be it the judicial system in the country or any system in a company, it has its own time. And I think sometimes you need to see that time through. You know, it's not that somebody complains today and tomorrow morning you get an answer. That's also not smart. Okay, so I think the thing is, it must be a fair system. A fair system which comes with the best answer, as opposed to a quick system which comes with the wrong answer. That's right. What I would say.
You know, ASCI has often had tiffs with the likes of Patanjali, which has not conformed to the ASCI codes. How can a body like ASCI ensure that, what is it doing in order to bridge the gap with companies like Patanjali, which time and again are in the defaulters list and are refusing to acknowledge the sanctity of a body like ASCI?
Sure. So that is the very nature of self-regulation. You can't change that. So the only way is to broaden the base, bring as many new members in as possible, so that there is so much more, you know, what I would say, moral pressure on companies to follow what is right vis-a-vis the consumer.
My last question to you, Mr. Shivakumar, is that, you know, you've been at PepsiCo earlier, and a couple of times PepsiCo was also pulled up for some of the advertisements that it released. But how does a brand look at the advertisings that are being flagged off by ASCI?
Good question, thank you. If you belong to an industry, then many times you have to take an industry view rather than a company view. So if PepsiCo at that point of time when I was chairman belonged to that industry called soft drinks and food and beverage, and ASCI ruled against it, PepsiCo said, thank you, you're right, and we will change it. Okay, that's the only way to do it. Exactly, going back to your question on Patanjali, if each member of ASCI says, I don't agree with this decision, then you do not have a self-regulation body. Then you have, you know, everybody on his own, which is not the objective of ASCI.
One of the central levers to raising awareness about ASCI and encouraging consumers to directly lodge complaints over false and misleading advertisements has been the launch of ASCI's WhatsApp number in 2016. Shweta Purandare, the Secretary General for ASCI, says that while the response to the WhatsApp number has been encouraging, the lack of trust in the redressal system is still prevalent. Acknowledging that self-regulation has its limitations as far as enforcement is concerned, Purandare says she hopes the government's Consumer Protection Bill 2018 will lend more teeth to ASCI.
Year on year, the number of complaints that come through WhatsApp, I could say about 15% of the ads that we look into, the source of these complaints is through our WhatsApp number. However, I find that typically in India, generally the tendency to register a complaint, people hesitate, or people don't have, maybe they don't trust the system as much. So it is not just specific to the world of advertising, it's everywhere in the sphere of life. So first and foremost, we want to increase awareness about ASCI, so people reach out to ASCI. The Consumer Protection Bill is getting revamped, and we do see hopefully some role where ASCI and ASCI code gets recognized. And with Consumer Protection Act getting more strong, lending teeth to our, the compliance percentage. And I think that's the right model to follow. ASCI is only one mechanism for a consumer to have their grievance redressed. But other forums are always open. Suppose some advertiser is not complying, the consumer has a right to approach the state consumer forum. They could approach NCDRC, because we are all about industry who is willing to regulate themselves. For those advertisers who are not really recognizing self-regulation, then the regulator is the only option.
It is time for us to slip into a short break. On the other side,